It's not that we are making preparation only because of this third wave. This preparation has been going on right from the first time when we were hit by COVID. And a lot of the measures, of course, when things had improved, then we had started to allow the inmates to meet with their relatives. Now, because it's been a long time that they have not been able to meet up with the relatives. And if things worsen, probably we'll have to close that down also. But the thing is now, one facility that we have given to all the inmates is that they can communicate with their relatives and their loved ones now, anytime that they wish to, on mobile. If telephone is not working, then definitely on mobile.
Can you tell us about the status of the prisoners here? How many and you?
That superintendent jail. How many people, inmates are there right now?
Is there any overcrowding?
How many? How much?
487.
There is overcrowding. I don't deny the fact.
What are the measures to ease the
overcrowding?
Long term basis, I should say, trying to completion of the Knox Town District Jail and setting up the Central Jail. And these are the long term measures that we are taking up. But still the time that these new jails come up, then we'll have to bear with it.
What should be the actual strength?
167.
How did this idea come about you know, listing these jailers in these kind of activities? How did this idea come about?
Idea came about, you see, the thing is, we wanted to change our perception of jails, you know. And because you see, the thing is, most of the time our people inside, they have just from morning to evening till they go back to their cells, they're literally idle. Okay, and they have nothing to do. And once they leave the come out on bail or probably after the conviction, there's no employment opportunities for them. And that is because they have been lingering here for a very, very long time. And with no, so we thought that at least let them have, you know, certain activities which will help them when once they come out of their prison.
So when do we expect the government to really come up with the central jail?
Government is very keen on coming out very shortly, and we do hope that it's a matter of time. But of course, building that kind of infrastructure will take quite a long time, and we hope that it will come out shortly. But of course, now the first thing that what they have done is that at least the minute we send a proposal, government has keenly taken up, and they have given us 25 acres of land. So that itself indicates that government is very keen on getting this central jail set up.
So when do we expect the construction work?
You see, the thing is, construction work will start only after the master plan has been done. And we had visited these good central jails outside, along with the architects from PWD, Chief Architect PWD, and looking at the good things that, good practices and the good things that they have over there. And though, of course, we are not going to implement on the scale that they are going, but probably on a smaller scale.
So can we say with the coming up of the, you know, the central jail, there will be the segregation of the convicted?
Definitely. In fact, that's the whole idea of having a central jail. The whole idea of having a central jail is that convicts will be separated, segregated from the UTPs. That's the whole idea.